Shruti Lekha, a very active and energetic, now a young lady, will now share her stay at Cottons, representing Standard 10.
Twelve years ago, a rather intimidated young child walked up to the imposing gates of Bishop Cotton Girls High School. She clutched her mother's hand, unwilling to go in. Today, life has come a full circle. She clutches her mother's hand yet again as she walks out of these doors with a heavy heart, yearning every moment to go back to this place, the place which is her home. Goodbye. I remember how our campus resonated with it and responded to it each morning. I've often stood in the assembly listening to it, and I found it no different than any other word, hardly realizing any feeling or depth in it. It is only when I have to say it do I really understand what it means. The years spent in the school have been a glorious experience. We will all look back to them with a wistful longing and thrill. Leaving school seems like leaving a part of me behind. All the joys of childhood and adolescence that will never, never come back again. Leaving behind those mornings when we would drag ourselves to the assembly and then sprint back to class to get the papers. Leaving behind those times when we would congregate in the cafeteria at break time to drown our sorrows in a plate of pani puri. Leaving behind both those sleepy afternoon classes as well as that excited buzz of a school activity. Leaving behind the football and the basketball games, dances, and especially time spent with a group of friends just doing whatever. But then I ask myself, I am now a part of the history of this glorious institution. Will I ever be able to leave Cottons? The education that I have received may take me far across the seas, but will I ever leave Cottons in spirit? Or will Cottons leave me? The answer is a reassuring no. I have enjoyed getting to know the children, helping them with their problems, correcting their mischief, and above all, remembering myself in the same position a couple of years back and smiling to myself. Now, I ask you to look at my friends and seniors, the graduating class. I can tell you how this one used to fight with me in nursery, or that one used to tie my shoelace in kindergarten. I can tell you how each and every one of us has experienced a mosaic of emotions, triumph, elation, determination, grit, the pangs of adolescence, and the power of knowledge. But today, we stand before you, mature young women, ready to face anything this world can throw at us. Today, as our school song says, we will remain keen until our hair turns grey. Because this is the power that is Cottons. This transition has by no means been an easy one. But when you have God playing so many different roles in one single life, all you have to do is walk along. Our principal, vice principal, teachers, support staff, and every single person we have come into contact with in our school is responsible for this transition. With such dedicated personalities backing us unflinchingly, we are sure to succeed in all our endeavors. They have painstakingly woven the most beautiful ideals of life into the tapestries of our lives, and they deserve all the commendation they can get. The years spent in the school have been a glorious experience. With the support of our God Almighty, our parents, teachers, and friends, we have made it to this day and to the beginnings of a new stage of our lives. Where we go from here and what new frontiers we are meant to discover may remain unseen. But as we walk out of these doors tonight and face into the world and stare into the first lights of what is to come, we shall always remember tonight's victory. For no matter what tomorrow brings, tonight we share an achievement. An episode of our lives is over, and perhaps the most important one. But the greatest happiness lies in the fact that it couldn't have been more memorable. I would also wish to thank the principal and the vice principal for giving me the opportunity to serve as a prefect and for all their support and encouragement. Graduation is a time to look back at the past few years. As students of Shakespeare, we can rattle off things about parting being a sweet sorrow. But I am not sorrowful. I am not afraid to step out into the world and face its challenges. For I have a glorious set of values and ideals backing me. I know that wherever I go from here, I will be true to Cotton's and hence true to myself. The only sadness I have right now is that I'll be meeting most of you next at the board exams. So, to paraphrase Richard Bach, don't be dismayed at goodbyes. A farewell is necessary before you can meet again. And meeting again, after moments or a lifetime, is certain for those who are Cottonians. Class of 2010, congratulations and on straight on.
A warm, vibrant person with excellent leadership qualities, which have been honed over the 4 years that she served as prefect, Shrutileka Kar, our school captain, has been an asset to this school. She is a talented artist, dancer, and musician, as well as a formidable debater, in addition to excelling at academics. She will now share with us some of her thoughts on life at Cotton's.
The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams, says Eleanor Roosevelt. I'm sure that each one of you has a different dream, but surely you should never give up your dreams and aspirations, for it is those aspirations that will drive you to higher levels of achievement and make your life purposeful. I stand before you today acknowledging this truth. I'd like to quote our former Honorable President, Dr. Kalam. When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. Respected Right Reverend S. Vasant Kumar, Bishop Karnataka Central Diocese, Vice Chairman, Board of Management, Reverend Daniel Ravi Kumar, our respected chief guest, Mr. K. Jayaraj, Additional Chief Secretary, Government of Karnataka, Reverend J. Soundarajan, Area Chairman, Bangalore Civil Area, members of the Board of Management, former principals of our diocesan schools and colleges, principal, vice principal, distinguished faculty, honored graduates, relieved parents, family and friends, a very good evening. It's a distinct pleasure to be in Bishop Cotton Girls' School this evening to celebrate the biggest milestone to date in the lives of the young women before you, the batch, the graduation of the batch of 2012 of Bishop Cotton Girls. It takes a minute to say hello and forever to say goodbye. It's so hard to part. In a few days, we will go on our separate paths and face the big, tough world, away from the cozy, secure, and warm environs we have been enjoying here. Aristotle said that the roots of education are bitter, but the fruit is sweet. I can't find a more perfect description of our school experience than that. For majority of the students, including me, many of our school days started with an alarm and then the question, why 8:15? For us, the excitement of being in college is coming. A lot of days in school have been a struggle, but we've been there for each other as classmates and friends to pull each other through. We have learned to love, to fight, to differentiate between right and wrong, and above all, to foster unity in diversity. I have learned the true value of friendship. I have met such amazing people here. This place is truly special. I'm glad that I got 6 years to make friends and was lucky to be under the tutelage of some of the finest teachers and guides than one can dream of. And now I have a lifetime to cherish them. Here at Bishop Cotton Girls, I have learned that one's problems are as big as one perceives them to be. It has taught me to introspect. It has given me opportunities to mend myself. It has taught me to think, to dream, and to pursue my dreams. It has taught me to trust myself, pick myself up whenever I went wrong and faltered. It has taught me to try harder to make things work just as I dreamt. This institution has taught me the power of silence. This institution has taught me to succeed. When I say this institution, I mean the principal, the vice principal, the teachers, the staff, the gardens where I spent my quiet moments, the buildings where I found a new me every day, my seniors who've taught me so much, my classmates who've been inspiring throughout, my juniors who've been a constant source of support, and the lovable kiddos who've been so loving and affectionate to me. All of them are so special that the essence of Bishop Cotton Girls stands incomplete, even if one were to be taken away. It may surprise you, graduates, but as great a night as this is for you, it's an even greater night for your parents. They may seem calm and collected as they sit in the audience, but deep inside, they are doing cartwheels, dancing the Macarena, and practically speaking in tongues. They are so excited. So, for everyone here this evening, it's a very special occasion, and I'm delighted to share it with you. Our challenges may be new. The instruments with which we meet them may be new. But those values upon which our success depends, honesty and hard work, courage and fair play, tolerance and integrity, loyalty and patriotism have been the quiet force of progress throughout the history of Cottons. What is demanded then is a return to these truths. What is required of us now is a new era of responsibility, a recognition on the part of every Cottonian that we have duties to ourselves, to our nation and the world. Duties that we do not grudgingly accept, but rather seize gladly. Firm in the knowledge that there is nothing so satisfying to the spirit, so defining of our character, than to give our all to a difficult task. And finally, to the batch of 2012, my friends, my peers, Martin Luther King claimed, intelligence plus character, that is the true goal of education. And undoubtedly, such a goal is reached within our 14 years of schooling here at Bishop Cotton Girls. Every face here holds a different hope, prospect, and experience.
It is, however, the individuality that defines you all as an unforgettable group of people. Whether it has been acknowledging each other in the corridor with a simple nod of the head, going out to dinner or a party, or simply speaking on the phone for hours. In the end, it has been the time spent together that will be missed and cherished. As George W. Bush said, to those of you who received honors, awards, and distinctions, I say, well done. And to the C students, I say, you too may be one day President of the United States. Class of 2012, let's remember our time here. Let's continue to graduate every day of our lives. And let's never lose our drive to succeed. It has taken me 6 long years to experience what I summed up in my 6-minute attempt to capture what I feel today. And yet, instead, I feel I could have just walked away without saying anything as insignificant as my speech, just by saying the 7 golden words that shall remain unparalleled for the rest of my life. I am proud to be a Cartonian. Class of 2012, congratulations, and on, straight on.
Thank you, Shruti Lekha, for that candid expression of your thoughts and experiences at Cotton's.